Going to see Druid versus Druid, Gorecki versus Rub Cub. Will the Rejects be able to take down the boys yet again?
I think in this specific case, Rub Cub at least doesn't have to deal with Trill's Demon Hunter, but now he's got to deal with Gorecki's Feral Affinity, and Gorecki is an all-star on that specialization. I'm really excited to see how he performs here against the Rejects in the lower bracket. That added extra damage might be what his team needs to find victory. The Rejects pull the trigger and go aggressive, but Seth Curry falls behind all of a sudden out of nowhere. Huge trades early on the part of the Reject to survive that initial engagement.
Yes, yeah, Seth Curry traded out a lot. No Transcendence as well. No Touch of Karma. If Chun-Li and Spexen can stay on target, it could be trouble. Full leg sweep. Will Jamili go peel mode and play a little bit defensive, or is he just going to kind of try to find some counter pressure? Full Polymorph now secured by Jamili on Gorecki. Decent pressure on Chun-Li and Smexen, but the damage just isn't there. Anytime Gorecki gets caught into the Polymorph, that's when it's not a bad time for Chun-Li and Smexen to just run at Jamili, throw an interrupt, and that really limits his offensive capability.
All right, they got a good crowd control chain on Gorecki, but Death Knights are a stickler for being able to heal themselves with Death Strike, so Smexen looks unfazed despite that crowd control chain. Seth Curry in a bit of danger, Rub Cup trinkets to try and deny the kill. Definitely big pressure from the boys early on, blowing through major defensive objectives within just minutes of the game starting and potentially now capable of closing it out shortly. Rub Cub gets cycloned up. Love to see maybe Gorecki get in there with that Feral Affinity. At the moment, just looking to crowd control Rub Cub. He's looking for a re-stealth, maybe for a Rake Sun, not going to find it. They catch Rub Cub with a Polymorph. Critical mistake. Rub Cub or Gorecki now trying to re-stealth maybe. No, looks for a Cyclone, gets denied on it. Now Gorecki jumps in and stuns Jamili while he was counterspelled. Really nice play there on Gorecki's part, just maximizing his global cooldown. Shifts out to dodge the Hibernate of Rub Cub. Good awareness there to avoid it, but in midfield he is exposed still to crowd control. Seth Curry getting gripped back into the fight. Smexen trying to build up some necrotic strikes. Gorecki again gets a re-stealth, stuns up, cyclones Rub Cub all over him right now with crowd control, looking to blow through that Touch of Karma that Seth Curry currently has available, but crowd control chain is not long. Maybe it is stolen Polymorph. Nice play by Smexen.
Yeah, Jamili needs to be careful. He's just giving Smexen free Polymorph after free Polymorph. Needs to start faking out those Dark Simulacrums in this matchup. Now a bash on Rub Cub. Gorecki charging in, looking for damage on Seth Curry. Very nicely done by Jamili. Nice. Shuts down that Cyclone attempt by Gorecki. And now, ultimately, Seth Curry still the one in trouble with no Touch of Karma. Caught into a full stun, but a huge heal from Rub Cub tops him off. He should be able to survive. He also has his Transcendence if he needs to portal away, but it's just in midfield. Both Monk's portal positioning is unideal in this certain situation. They're both in the middle of the map.
Gorecki just re-stealthing, and then Rub Cub re-stealths out of the Cyclone to avoid being raked, stunned, as both Druids are just going at each other with crowd control to try and close this match out. Chun-Li now starting to get blasted by the Rejects as Rub Cub looks to secure crowd control. Polymorph, was it Dark Simulacrum? This is the question. We're going to find out here shortly if Smexen decides to commit it. Chun-Li is still on the back foot, though. He's trying to trade Fortifying Brew, but that may not be enough defense. Touch of Karma now used at the same time. Bit of a defensive overlap. Gorecki again setting up crowd control for his team. So when you are locked down in a Cyclone or a Polymorph, you will drop Combat after extended time in that crowd control, which means you can activate Prowl. And then with Gorecki running Feral Affinity, you can use Rake, and from Prowl, Rake activates a stun. So Gorecki is constantly looking for any opportunity to drop Combat, such as now, so he can stun Seth Curry, bounce over to Rub Cub, stun him, and look for a Cyclone. The Feral Affinity is definitely a lot of fun to play. Pretty difficult to actually execute, but if you're interested in trying it, you definitely want to watch Gorecki.
Yeah, he's been doing an excellent job showcasing that talent specialization during these tournaments. Now leg sweep on a Chun-Li, a little bit of burst damage coming in. Smexen responds with the anti-magic zone. That's going to be really limiting the amount of damage that Jamili is able to do. Seth Curry actually commits his Touch of Death onto Chun-Li, and Chun-Li doesn't really have too much of an answer. Gorecki has to back him up with the Iron Bark. Incapacitate lands from Seth Curry on a Gorecki. Chun-Li could still be in a little bit of trouble, but he's looking like he's going to be able to tank through this damage. Seth Curry has a lot of offensive capabilities with the Serenity. They can catch anyone in a stun, they might be able to take him down.
It's actually just hilarious watching Gorecki run around the map, re-stealth, stun one person, re-stealth, stun the next person, then cyclone them. He just has complete control of the battlefield here.
It's like a sub-rogue.
Game number. He is like a sub-rogue, just jumping over onto different targets, finally getting cloned up by Rub Cub, showing some sass on the Restoration Druid himself. but his team just lacks the pressure to really push it over the edge. Jamili on the back foot here. Huge damage. Double leg sweep as they look to close. The boys look to take down the rejects with tons of damage, gripping Jamili back into the fight. Ursul's Vortex on the blink, but as Arcane, you have access to a lot of those, so Jamili is able to finally get to safety.
Yeah, a lot of blinks, but Jamili basically used all of them. I'm not sure what he ice blocked earlier in the game, potentially just using it offensively, wanting to break crowd control. We've seen Jamili use that as an ability many times in the past. Now Gorecki looking for a Cyclone, finds it on to Jamili, slowing down any incoming heals. And now if they have any CC for RubCub, Jamili could be in a lot of trouble. There's the Asphyxiate. Jamili, he has no defense left. He has to do a good job kiting. Ring of Peace has already been used. Chun-Li, beautifully done, knocks him back right on top of him. All three members on Jamili. Gorecki potentially looking for a Cyclone. He gets interrupted there. Nicely done by Jamili. That's one of the only things that's keeping him alive.
Yeah, most certainly is. But look at the mana, that Feral Affinity Pain, its weight, the Death Knight's consistent pressure as well, as the Dark Simulacrum Chrom is way more valuable in this specific matchup. And Jamili is against the wall in game number one. They'll lose the blind pick advantage if they lose here. RubCub looks for crowd control. Gorecki dodges the Hibernate. He's actually low on health. Seth Curry switches his attention. You can definitely swap to a Druid running this Feral Affinity and look to punish it. Maybe if they have a leg sweep, they can catch him with the Touch of Death. Not able to find it. Jamili still just trying to avoid death, but really having a hard time.
Yeah, still 3 minutes left on that ice block, and RubCub's mana is not looking good. Gorecki once again looking for a re-stealth, cosplaying a subtlety rogue in this matchup, like we said, constantly going for the re-stealths, getting the rake stuns, looking for the bashes. Jamili getting low. Iron Bark might not be enough to keep him alive. Trying to cut away on the Arcane Mage. Beautiful Ring of Peace once again, keeping Jamili there. Svexen needs to be able to reconnect, but Seth Curry's trying to counter pressure. Nicely done. Touch of Death is used on Svexen. He could be in some trouble, but ultimately Jamili falls, getting soloed down there by Chun-Li. And the boys looking like they may have found the answer, because I think this is the matchup that sent them down to the lower bracket. Yep. But with a little bit of time,
Jax can show us how they did in the first place.
And Seth Curry's going to be opting to switch up his talents in this matchup. No longer going to be going for the Serenity, which I like. I feel like the Serenity play could work, and maybe that's what initially caught the boys off guard. The Tigra Brew and Serenity, it's a lot of burst damage in those burst windows, but you lose out on a lot of consistent pressure. So Seth Curry opting to go with Zwen and Storm Earth and Fire. It's going to be more consistent damage in this game, and I think it's going to be a lot more threatening for Chun-Li and Smexen.
Yep, definitely could be, as Seth Curry changes some talents to try and catch the opposing team off guard. No guessing there. Feral Affinity for Gorecki once again. On this larger map, though, it can be difficult to traverse since you're spending so much time in Prowl crossing to fight. I love that while he's counterspelled and can't cast heals, he utilizes a couple of global cooldowns in cat form to get a bit of extra damage. I mean, just that tiny bit of extra damage right there got Touch of Karma for his team, and it's definitely carrying here for the boys, but now caught in crowd control as Seth Curry looks to try and fight back against Chun-Li. Chun-Li rolling out of the battle. Ring of Peace to knock Seth Curry away from the reconnect. Maledict flies in from RubCub, though, absorbing these Vivify. Seth Curry sees the opportunity, tries to seize it, but Chun-Li immediately retreats back to the center of the field, but it still may not be enough. Once if meant, another Maledict dispelled. Pressure is still mounting. Chun-Li in trouble, but now reverses with a double leg sweep. Chun-Li now gets reversed on by Seth Curry of a leg sweep of his own. Huge damage! 1 second away! Is able to survive the stun lock. Now a full Cyclone onto Gorecki. The damage is staggeringly higher for the rejects here in game two.
Yeah, Chun-Li, he managed to hold on to that Touch of Karma the entire time, so that will be available for him if he really needs it. And RubCub used a lot of mana looking for Cyclones in that duration. Chun-Li is going to be trading out a Touch of Karma for the Touch of Death of Seth Curry. That should be able to keep him alive, but they burst through it. Chun-Li still very vulnerable in this matchup. Jamili trading out an ice block, I believe, aggressively. They thought they could potentially take Chun-Li down with that Touch of Death. I think he blocked the Karma, and that's a really risky move. If Chun-Li can survive, that puts the rejects way behind.
Yeah, Gorecki's still Cycloned. Seth Curry trying to take this game out. Gorecki moves in, gets counterspelled instantly. Nice counterspell. But then that means Gorecki will go cat form, start dealing some damage and stun locking the team. No ice block as Jamili used it aggressively to try and find a kill and didn't find it. Now he's just behind on defense. Gorecki just constantly stunning up the enemy team. Finally gets stalled out by a paralysis from Seth Curry. Now pressure on Seth Curry. He has to use Touch of Karma. And out of all of the cleaves I've seen in the tournament scene so far, the boys definitely deal the most damage. And Adding in Gorecki's extra crowd control is putting them over the edge, but finally some counter pressure. Chun-Li dips below half. Gorecki's locked down in a cyclone. Chun-Li once again needs to retreat. Ursel's Vortex pins him. Well done by Rub Cub, allowing Seth Curry to finally connect, but now Chun-Li transcendence back to midfield. He has his portal on top of it. Nice moves by Seth Curry.
Yeah, Seth Curry doing a good job hunting down Chun-Li. Chun-Li has to survive. He has a touch of death. They might be able to take down Jamili if they have any more crowd control. Temporal Shield was just used. There's an opportunity for the boys here. There's the touch of death. Stun on Jamili. Stun on Rub Cub. Once again, Smexen on point with the spell steals. Rub Cub in a full polymorph. Jamili falls. The boys, amazing crowd control and burst. Excellently done.
Probably wish you had your ice block.
Right, we got some strats from you guys in the chat. You guys saying that you want to see Jamili potentially hold that ice block until he is dead. I don't know if that's going to be what works, but they need to try to take some of your advice because the boys are on an absolute tear, looking to send the team that sent them to the lower bracket packing, looking to send them home. This game can be the one that does it.
Yes, Seth Curry going back to Serenity, it looks like. So didn't like this Warmth and Fire whirling Dragon Punch. Jamili taking a little bit of pressure. It seems like the boys, they're very comfortable sitting on Jamili now, bursting him down, almost killing him instantly. Goodness gracious, what an absurd amount of damage onto Jamili, trying to use the Temporal Shield to absorb, but it was just too much. Had to trade out the Ice Block in the first few seconds of this game.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this might be the last game of the day as the boys assert dominance in the lower bracket, already blowing through the most of the defense of the Rejects within seconds of this fight starting. The Rejects need to pull off something quick. They've got an opportunity maybe to take Chun-Li down if they can properly execute on it with Touch of Death and Zwen the Tiger. Seth Curry can initiate a huge push. Chun-Li does not have a Glider's Medallion to get out of a leg sweep. Seth Curry, though, is the one who's falling behind. Turbo Fist protects him, parrying the incoming attacks to restabilize. I want to see Seth Curry go for that kill. He's only got 27 more seconds to do it. Instead, maybe opting to go for a different target. Paralysising up Gorecki. Not able to find a stun just yet onto Chun-Li. Jamili getting Ring of Peace back into the cleave. Well done by Chun-Li. Gorecki now looking to sneak away. Anytime he's interrupted or crowd control, he constantly looks to prowl. Rub Cub jumps on his face, looking for a hibernate. Doesn't manage to actually snag any crowd control whatsoever. Chun-Li falling behind. 2 seconds away from that window of opportunity. Now it is lost. Chun-Li will be able to trinket in touch with Karma. In the meantime, another polymorph was stolen by Smexen. MVP Smexen here in this series gets the Gladiator's Medallion from Rub Cub. If Jamili gives one more polymorph to Smexen, this game is over.
Yeah, this is very dangerous for the Rejects at this point in the game. Jamili, no ice block. Rub Cub, no trinket left with no Iron Bark. There's a window of opportunity here for Chun-Li. If he's patient with the Touch of Death, if they can get the Iron Bark, they might be able to just close out the game. Seth Curry getting low as well. There's multiple pressure points here for the boys. What are the Rejects going to do? Jamili tries to deny with the Temporal Shield. Touch of Death ticking down for Chun-Li. Almost available for him. Who is he going to use it on? Rub Cub activates his Iron Bark, and now this is the moment that they need. The boys, they can close out this game. Jamili is so vulnerable. Once that Iron Bark fades, there is no defense left, and I think the boys are looking like they could 3-0 this series.
Seth Curry getting cycloned at low health, making things difficult for Rub Cub to recover the team. Now getting rake stunned by Gorecki as he looks to rotate that clone over to Rub Cub. Now in cat form, dishing pain out towards Jamili. Smexen marching his way over, would just like to be hitting Jamili, but Seth Curry is keeping him snared up, making it difficult to connect. But now all three members have damage rolling onto Jamili. There's no defense for 8 more seconds.
Touch
race against the clock. That temporal shield has a few more seconds. Can Jamili buy that couple of seconds? Gorecki gets stunned up. He can't keep up the chase. Touch of Death explodes. Jamili barely recovers. Rub Cub's almost tapped on mana. It's match point. They're against the wall. There's really no opportunities for them whatsoever. And if one polymorph is Dark Simulacrum by Smexen, this game could close. Smexen commits that Dark Simulacrum. What spell is Jamili going to give to him? Not a polymorph, fortunately, for Rub Cub.
Yep, Seth Curry getting low. He trades out the Touch of Karma. Now there's two vulnerable targets on the Rejects. Rub Cub once again into a full cyclone. Gorecki just playing so aggressive. Seth Curry trying to shut that down by running back. Doesn't want any follow-up crowd control. Jamili left all alone. Rub Cub has to keep him alive with the Iron Bark. Chun-Li and Smexen still all over him. Jamili's under so much pressure in this game. Seth Curry comes to back him up. Serenity does get used. Can they take down Smexen? Smexen with the anti-magic shell should be able to survive. Millie with a beautiful temporal shield tops himself off. But if we look at mana, Rubcub has just been having to use so much mana in this matchup. He's almost completely oomed so early on.
Ooh, double leg sweep. Chun-Li wants to close this game out. There's still no defense for Jamili. Seth Curry is feeling the pain as well as Chun-Li and Smexen push to close the match. Nothing left. Seth Curry on the run. Is he going to be able to escape to safety? Gurecki keeps the chain going. He's got a Ring of Peace to try and deny Fists of Fury. That Turbo Fist parry and some attacks, but even still, now Cyclone at low health. If Gurecki can get a stun here on Rubcub, it's going to be curtains for Seth Curry. Rubcub gets out of the crowd control, is actually able to hold on to Ironbark, surprisingly not panicking under that pressure. Holds on to the cooldown, but his mana is just looking abysmal. I don't see any opportunities for them, and the boys are just walking all over them.
Seth Curry, with beautiful kiting there, was able to escape with his Transcendence. Rubcub was able to hold on to that Ironbark. Once again, Gurecki going for the stun, looking for a Cyclone. Jamili backs up Rubcub with that counterspell, slowing down the crowd control chain. Now Chun-Li taking a little bit of damage. Jamili finding some Arcane Blast. He gets topped off. Ironbark is used by Gurecki. Now doesn't have that defensive cooldown to really fall back on. And there is a lot of burst potential here for Seth Curry. He has a Touch of Death. He has Zwen. He has Serenity. Basically everything he needs to take him down. But Jamili is the one that's under most under pressure. There's a full bash on Rubcub. He got the Ironbark up before that crowd control chain. That should keep Jamili alive. And at this point in the game, Jamili actually has his Ice Block rotating back up, and this isn't too bad for Rejax besides the mana for Rubcub.
But Smexen managed to snag a Polymorph, I'm wondering there. He's moving his way. I don't think he was able to, but we will find out soon if he did. Chun-Li landing a double stun. Cyclone Seth Curry's Trinket. Chun-Li gets the crowd control. They're executing for a kill. Jamili has Ice Block available this time around. He can make the trade. He's trying to hold on to it for a little bit later into the fight, but Gurecki jumps in with a huge Ferocious Bite, almost closing that game out right there. Jamili stays in it. Rubcub's totally tapped. Gurecki still has half mana in the tank. Dampening has just engaged. The Rejects, they can't get away. They can't get a drink. They can't get a reset, and I don't think they can get a kill. What can they get?
I don't know. They can try to hold on a little bit longer. There's the bash onto Gurecki. Once again, is Rubcub going to be able to get any follow-up crowd control? It doesn't look like it, and Jamili's been left all alone. He uses the temporal shield well-timed, but still, Chun-Li all over him. Smexen gets Nova'd away. Will he be able to reconnect? He is. Now this is a scary moment for Jamili. Rubcub, no mana, no Ironbark, no temporal shield. All the boxes have been checked for the boys. Can they finally close out this game 3-0-ing the Rejects?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this could be the last game of the day. You don't want to go anywhere. The pressure is mounting, and the boys are looking like they're going to close. Grip into a double stun. Jamili able to blink to safety. Perhaps enough to stay alive. Maybe not. There's no mana left in the tank. Jamili on the run. Rubcub with nothing left, and Gurecki all over him. One more Ferocious Bite connects. Gurecki looking for a clone at low health. Doesn't manage to get Innervate available for Rubcub. That makes all of his healing free. He can catch a couple of big heals, keep Jamili alive, and at least stay in the fight. Maybe for an opportunity to kill Gurecki. Gurecki has been so overly aggressive and overextended in this fight. If they can catch him, maybe they can take him down. Gurecki now reverses. Full Cyclone. Temporal Shield has now been counteracted. Huge damage, and the boys look to close. Offensive Touch of Karma. Gurecki continues the crowd control chain. Now a Paralysis, and Jamili will fall. The boys 3-0 the Rejects, and they are back in the lower bracket.
The boys have destroyed the lower
round to the compositions and the picks as well, but also in some of these matches I do believe it's a lot of in-game strategy. I don't think the boys changed much in terms of composition against the Rejects. They just changed a little bit of what they were doing perhaps in those games, and now it just looks like a completely different series. And I mean, the boys, they have a really strong comp as well in the current meta. They're going to be going up against the Move tomorrow. That's going to be a nail biter for sure, because the Move, they somehow they have just been slaying Goliath after Goliath.
Yeah, I mean, you look at the other three teams, and they're